Ayo, I live a normal life, discreet, but last night was deep. I laid down with the wife to sleep. Drifted off, but somehow my body must have lifted off, cause the next thing I knew I went and exited the loft. Had my main man, Daryl Tarver, waiting in the charger. He had stolen off the father of a chick that went to Harvard. I got up in the Dodge and somehow I knew the plan was a dude who grew the grams, enjoying a nigga Ruba Sand. So he went to boost the stash, nobody wasn't home. This cat was getting fat up off the packets of his dough. My homeboy Steve was following in the Jeep, and my man Connor Rook was in the passenger seat. He got a tip from a fiend who smoked crack on a sneak, and went and told about the boss. Said he packed for a week to go and slack on the beach. That was when we made the move, riding out to Robert's house for all his cash and his jewels. Parked the cars in an abandoned line and walked for 20 minutes. Carried duffel bags with clothes and ski masks, but when we finished, supplies were in the backpack that Steve had carried with us. So we busted out the gadgets, and this was how we did it. Lifted Connor to the terrace, and he climbed up on the chimney. Then he jimmied the lock, was in the attic in a jiffy. Took a saw to the rafters and was on the second floor. Jetted off, knew his job was to go and get the door. Who was knocking? Maximilian, of course. I know just what I'm looking for. The safe where the bounty is stored. We had Steve looking out in case County was born. Daryl went to crack the lock while we scoured for more. Connor took the living room, I took the master and guest. And it was there I found a necklace that was fast to impress. It could have been 1,000 carats, must have got it for the marriage. Told myself I wasn't leaving till I stuffed it in the baggage. Necklace was a specimen of infinite worth. The jewels wrapped around the gold were laid with intricate work. Rubies, emeralds, and pearls, sapphires for girls, with a diamond that appeared to be the size of the world. I descended down the stairs and Daryl was still there. As the safe swung open, we just gathered and stared. There was money to the ceiling, but what interested me was when we cleared out the cheddar, all was left was a key. Not a key that you could free base and sell on the street. It was the type that you could use to get to where you need to be. It seemed to me there was a single case the thing could unlock, the one that held the wifey's chain with the stones and the rock. So I snatched the piece of metal, started backtracking stat to where my backpack was at, so I could snatch that and scat. As soon as I had taken what I fiended to get, Steve said there was a problem and we needed to jet. Took the ill-gotten gains, then we made our escape. Steve said that Jake was coming to surround the estate. Took the backyard route, jumped the fence and we was out. Little did we know a helicopter lurked in the clouds. On the street where we emerged, there were cops on the curb. Fired tear gas at us, so our vision was blurred. As far as they were concerned, we were suckers sitting ducks. Saw the piggies gripping guns, we just put our hands up. Soon I heard myself scream, I ain't about to go yet. And it was then I woke up, covered in a cold sweat. Still in my own bed, I had to pinch a roll of flesh. Looked over at my wife and fixed my eyes below her head. Was a diamond on her breasts, I became a nervous wreck. Just then there was a call pressing, and answered yes, who is this? Detective Brown, precinct 47. We just need to ask a few questions.